Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Weren't we already dealing with so many things on a regular basis, like loans, finance, health, work pressure? And now there seems to be something bigger adding to it. The outbreak of this virus could have just made things so much more worse for all of us, especially if we are battling depression and anxiety. Fear about your health, work, and the health of your loved ones could be so overwhelming and cause such strong emotional responses in many of us. You could also be battling larger questions about your purpose and feeling so worthless and helpless. I'm sure these emotions could make you feel so heavy and even pull you down. What's more contagious than this pandemic is the fear and the sadness that is lurking with it. Depression is more than just feeling sad or going through a rough patch. It is a mental health condition. Depression certainly requires understanding and medical care. If depression is left untreated, it can be very devastating for those who have it and also for their families. If you currently are battling depression, then it is important for you to reach out and seek the help that you need. There are a few things that you could do. The first one is to get in touch with a mental health practitioner. Today, there are so many different free helpline numbers that you could use if you're feeling bottled up with emotions and you just want to talk it out. Many counselors have also extended their services in different creative ways. There are free webinars, talks, and even online one-on-one counseling sessions. These services can certainly help you open up, share, and also deal with your emotions in a safe space. The second thing is that at such times, it is important for you to get in touch with your social support groups. Now, this can be anybody, your friends, your family, or anyone in your community that you feel safe and comfortable with. We all need emotional support. This is a powerful way for us to deal with our overwhelming emotions. The third is that if you were already on medications before, then it is important that you continue to take these medicines. The fourth is to eat healthy and nourishing food. Now, it has been proved that the food you eat directly affects the structure and function of your brain, and ultimately your mood. Having nourishing food can have a positive impact on your mental health. The fifth is to exercise regularly. Now, exercise not only improves your physical health, but also your mental health. Exercising especially helps fight depression by increasing different neurotransmitters in your brain that regulate mood, sleep, and appetite. So make time for workouts. Stay fit, both physically and mentally. These steps can seem very simple, but let us not underestimate the power of these little things we can do to take care of ourselves. I know going through these emotional shifts can be so hard and could be even draining our energies. You know, one of the worst parts about depression is that it robs you of hope. A hope that things would get better. A hope that someday we would get through this. But we are resilient. We are capable of doing more than we think we can do. No matter how hopeless you feel right now, don't give up. Because hope and relief are real and possible. A word of caution. Now, this is just to bring to your awareness that some of us are guilty of using this word depression in our everyday conversations. And when we do that, we usually have something far less serious in our mind. Somehow, the word I am depressed has become a replacement for saying I'm actually feeling sad. It's like an umbrella term that we use to express any form or type of sadness that we may actually feel. Are you guilty of saying things like, I'm feeling so depressed, I missed my alarm this morning? Or, my meeting today was so depressing. What you probably mean over here is that you were feeling very bored in your meeting, or feeling a sense of urgency because you missed your alarm this morning. Most people use the word and don't even realize it. You probably think it's harmless. We probably are covering our so-called negative feelings with a larger word like depression, because of which we are probably not able to identify and process our emotions correctly. Now, the first step of dealing with any emotional difficulty begins by naming the emotion. So now let's explore a few alternate words that you could use to express the emotion of sadness. You could say that you're feeling lonely, feeling heartbroken, feeling disappointed, you're feeling unhappy, lost, feeling troubled, or even feeling miserable. I could go on, but I hope you get the point. When we are able to identify, label, and then express our emotions, we're in a better place to be able to respond to our feelings less reactively and more responsively. Remember that the words you say have a huge impact on your mood and on your mind. Stay aware, stay safe, and let us not forget that help is always available. You do not have to battle this all alone. God bless you.